Hey guys, how's it going? So it's been about a week now, or close to 2 weeks now, but I still kind of can't believe it. It's still something that is taking me a while to get used to. But I am a graduate student now. I've started graduate school. So that's kind of, it feels amazing, but yet at the same time, I still don't know quite how to feel about it. I don't feel like a graduate student. It's almost like I assume there's supposed to be this like feeling of prestige or feeling of grandeur or whatever, but there's not really that. Also, I'm not in the mood of being like a studious student. You know, I'm not like super diligent, super passionate, and super fresh like I was when I first entered, when I first came to New York City to go to NYU. I was just like, oh my gosh, I'm finally in college. You know, after having been in high school and junior high, this is like all that I prepare for, and now after all the preparations, after taking the SATs, after doing all the college applications and all that, finally here, doing college. You know, that sense of excitement, don't have it for graduate school. But it's still something that, like, it's surprising to me that I'm actually here now as a graduate student, which is kind of ironic considering the fact that this is something I've always planned to do. Ever since I, you know, started college as an undergraduate student, this is something that I always planned. Like, I know I have to do graduate school, and that's because I'm majoring in social work, and social work is a field that for many states, for densely populated states, and for states that have really great social programs, like New York, California, Illinois, Washington, Maryland, what have you, these kind of states require people to have master's degree in social work in order to actually even be considered to work as social workers. So if you want to work as a social worker in many states in the country, you can't unless you have a master's. So I know I've read a lot of comments on my like student debt videos, and people are like, oh, you don't need a degree to help people, which is in a general sense true. You don't. If you want to work in a nonprofit field, if you're able to, you know, to make start a business, make a great amount of money, and do philanthropy your type of way, or just help people out in your own way, don't need a degree for that. Definitely not. And in a way, every job, in a way, is kind of helping people in a way, because even if you're selling burgers, you're helping people's demand for burgers. The only problem is it depends on what kind of burgers you sell, because might not be healthy, whatever. But that's a whole other can of worms altogether. But the point is, you know, no matter what you're doing, you are kind of contributing to society in a way. So generally, that comment is true. You don't need a degree to help people to do good, but you do need a degree to be a social worker. In most states, I think most is the key word. Many rural states like Alabama, Tennessee, places like those, you only need a bachelor's. But they're picky though. People there are picky with like experiences. You need a great resume to actually be considered, but you only need the bachelor's in social work to be considered a social worker in many of those states. But many of those states have really bad standards for social workers. And I've kind of heard really bad stories about the social work field and about social workers in those kind of states, which makes sense because there's lower standards. In states like New York City, where social work opportunities are plentiful and awesome, and there's really, really great resources for people who need help, need assistance from social workers and such, standards are much, much, much higher. New York State, I think, is one of the states that have like the most rigorous standards. So not only do you need a master's degree, but you also need to have it licensed. So after I graduate with an MSW, I'm also going to have to get a work experience and be supervised and pass an exam to to change my MSW into an LMSW, or if I want to go into a clinical field, into an LCSW. But yeah, knowing all that about my field of social work, yeah, going to graduate school was always something I intended to do. It's just like always in my plan, but it kind of felt on the wayside because after graduating college, with the BSW, it's just like I want to get my hands dirty in a nonprofit work and really start just doing nonprofit work, whether it's actual social work career path or not. Like, I want to start building some experience before starting graduate school, which is why I ended up, you know, becoming a tutor for Champion Learning Center, going to homes and families of students who are low income and tutoring them. And then I ended up working in a homeless shelter. And that, I think, was the thing that really changed me in a way. That was an amazing experience in a way. Also kind of a not so amazing experience in a way. There's definitely a lot of positive, a lot of negatives that went with that experience. But when I started working there, it's just like, wow, this is the kind of experience that I've been trained to do. This is the kind of experience I need to build upon to really get further. And the question that I guess I have for myself, and this is a hypothetical question, is if I continued working there, if there was nothing bad that ever happened, if that thing didn't have to end the way it did for me, then when, at what point would I have been able to decide, like, okay, this is enough for me, now it's time for me to start graduate school? I don't think I've ever would have reached that conclusion easily, because it's something, working there, like, I was so, like, deeply involved in it, and I had got myself a little too comfortable just being a worker and not wanting to ever be like a student again. So I got into that mindset, and I think that was why maybe I can consider, you know, that ending could have been the one force that really propelled me toward this path of entering graduate school once again 3 years after having graduated from college with the BSW. It also kind of led me to a whole bunch of different areas, like political canvassing, which I did for a while. Decided it wasn't for me. took me a while to realize that, but learned about a lot of valuable experiences with that. It's not really in hindsight, I don't think it's really the activity of canvassing that's really what has me disillusioned, but the whole structure itself is set up in a way that irks me so much that I just decided, like, this isn't for me. So I was doing a lot of volunteering for a while, but while volunteering, like, it just gets to me, like, I need to pay rent. I have all these, like, life responsibilities, and, like, I don't know what my future is going to be with having just these experiences, which didn't even require college degrees, but actually high school degrees. But the way the market is right now, a lot of my coworkers at the homeless shelter, my job didn't require a college degree, at least on paper. But almost 90% of my coworkers had college degrees. Some were even going for their master's, already had their master's. Crazy. So that's really how competitive this market has become. Job scarcity is ridiculous. Unemployment rate is ridiculous right now. So, kind of having had that experience, I think, was really helpful in finally coming into this state where I'm entering graduate school. And that's now why I'm starting here. I feel a little hopeful. I don't know. It's definitely always something that I've intended to do. I just have to get my mind back to being like this student mode, and really making sure that I don't waste my time, you know, and I wake up early and I sleep early and I'm diligent about everything, because life for me is about to get super busy. Today, I just had my orientation with America Reads, which is going to be my part-time job. So I'm going to be working under America Reads, and America Reads and Counts, that's the organization. And I'm going to be working at least 2 days a week. My internship hasn't started yet, but I'm going to be starting that. That's going to be 3 days a week, and I have 4 courses. So all that compounded, it's going to have plenty of things to do, but I just have to get in the mindset of being like, you know, I can't be idling around anymore, and I think that's the thing that's going to really kind of shape me into being who I want to be by the end of this. So going to take 2 years to get my MSW, and I have no idea where I'm going to end up after that. The kind of thing that really shocked me going into here is when I was trying to get my bachelor's, I had a really great idea. Like, I knew where I was going. I had a solid plan. Like, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this. Like, it was so structured and so set. But now it's kind of like all over the place, you know. And when I was in college, an undergraduate student, I was really focused on homelessness and HIV and AIDS. and housing options and poverty. It was like that kind of thing I was super focused on. But now, like, I'm having, that stuff is still something that I'm super passionate about. But my part-time job is America Reads, which is going to schools and tutoring students and assisting teachers. And my internship is partnership with children, which is school social work, you know, working with school social workers. So now I'm like, I'm in a more education focus, and that's a completely different focus than what I've been used to. And also I'm getting this knowledge base from courses more on clinical approaches. So don't really know what kind of social work I'm going to be doing. I don't know what kind of social work I'd be like, you know, have that super fiery passion about. I don't know. I've had that passion about homelessness, but I've been really disillusioned after having worked in a homeless shelter. Not about the work, but there's still it's still such an important aspect. It's something that I've always considered, like, you know, people without homes are like the most in need, because that's like a basic fundamental need. If you don't have a roof over your head, like, how can you do anything else in your life? So it's always been like this huge concern of mine, but the system to fix that is what's really messed up, and that's what disillusioned me from that. But with education, at least the system is not, it's still really problematic. I mean, all systems in America and in many countries have problems, you know. But yeah, I don't know. So that's kind of me being like, I guess, a little bit more complex here. I think I was really naive looking back, and really idealistic, which I think is great. But sometimes it kind of blinds you from the reality of things. So, but the reality of things can also depress you. So they've got to maintain this balance, and I think that's important. And I think that's what I'm going to be trying to do. But that's pretty much my life currently. Now a graduate student, going to be a graduate student for about 2 more years. And who knows what will happen after that. But yeah, that's me. Hopefully that's a good update. So, cheers.